Die Invloed deur Piero Becker. The Influence by Piero Becker. Wanneer 'n jong man 'n meisie in sy hart lief gekry het, en sy liefde boonop beantwoord, is daar min dinge wat hom van haar af sal weghou. When a young man loves a girl with all his heart, and his love is returned, there are few things that will keep him from her. Die stokou reeltjies, sie konden by Malkander nie komen, het water was veel te diep, bestaan eenvoudig nie in sy liefdesbindel nie. The age-old lines that they could not reach each other because the water was too deep, did not exist in his love story. Bygesê natuurlik, as hy nie 'n slap hoofse minnaar is nie, maar 'n man met murg in sy bene. Added, of course, is that if he is not just a good lover, but also a man with bravery. A man met alles veil, selfs sy eie lewe, en bereid wees om dit te bewys. A man should be able to give up everything, even his life, and be ready to show it. In hierdie geval was die vurige jong man 'n visserseun van ons dorp, Wenning Nyland. In this case, it was a fiery young man, a fisher's son from our town, Wenning Nyland. 'N oop, regskape jongeling, wat elke dag wat die goeie vader gegee het, voluit gelewe het. An open, true person, young boy, young man, that every day used what the Lord gave him and lived to the fullest. Die meisie was Mila van der Wateren. The girl was Mila van der Wateren. Tussen hierdie twee minnaars, daaroor het die dorpse inwoners saamgestem, so die see self hom weldra kon uitstrek. So naby en tog so ver. Between these two lovers, and this is that the town's people agreed upon, is that even the sea could stretch itself between the two. So near, but yet so far. So naby en tog so ver. Verduidelik, ou waarnemers, graag hoe die twee uit die staanspoor vasgedraai was. Explain, old observers, eagerly, why these two were doomed from the start. Wenning was van geboorte af 'n seemens, 'n visser wat sy ambag op die water geleer het. Wenning was born a sea person, a fisherman who did his craft on the water and he learnt it there. So het iedereen hom aanvaar. Everyone accepted him this way, a brood uit die water mens. He made his living from the water. Iedereen, behalwe Mila se ma, everyone except Mila's mother. Hilde Sewes, so genoem na haar oorlede man Sewes. Hilde Sewes, so named after her dead husband Sewes, was 'n gesore landmens wat haar in 'n oomblik van swakheid laat meevoer het tot die bestaan van 'n visserman se vrou. She was a sworn earth person that in a moment of weakness agreed to be a fisherman's wife. Die swakheid het sy haarself nooit vergewe nie. This weakness she never forgave herself. Sy het net gelewe vir die dag wanneer sy nie meer na die verraderlike blou dam hoef te kyk vir elke dag se kos om te eet nie. She lived for the day that she didn't need to look and see the treacherous blue dam for the food that she needed to eat. Of Wenning lief sou geword het vir die see as hy in ander omstandighede groot geword het, is moeilik om te sê. Whether Wenning would have loved the sea as much as he does if he had grown up in different circumstances is difficult to say. Ook sy pa was 'n visser. His father was a fisherman. Soos die meeste hier, like most here. Maar ook anders, but also different. Die see was vir hom sy hartklop. The sea was his heartbeat. Op die see was hy in sy element. On the sea he was the best he could be. Op land was hy ontuis. On land he was uncomfortable, felt out of place, lomp soos 'n verdwaalde rotskalf, clumsy like a lost sea calf, stil in homself gekeer, quiet, introverted. Maar op die water het hy uitgevloei en saamgeborrel. Hy het elke môre gesing wanneer hy op die water uitgaan. But on the water, he flowed and he bubbled. He sang every morning when he went out. En van Speen uit af was saam met hom op die skei die seun wat sy tennerige vrou hom gegee het, voordat sy heeltemal weggekwyn het en dood is. Wyning, groot voor sy tyd, seemanskappie en al. And from very little, with him on his boat, was the son that his sickly wife gave him before she completely disappeared and died. Wyning, addled before his time, seaman's cap and all. Hilde Sewe se man is deur die see weggeneem. Op 'n helder middag het 'n storm uit die suide gekom en die water selfs in Vredenbaai hoër opgejaag as wat enige iemand kan onthou. Hilde Sewe's husband was taken by the sea. On a clear afternoon, a storm came from the south and pushed the sea, the water in Vredenbaai higher than what anyone can remember. 2 dae later is die skuit aan 'n rots gevind, asof dit 'n kapstok is waar die see hom gehang het. 2 days later, the boat was found, and it looked like a coat hanger where the sea just hung the boat. Nog 'n dag later is Sewes deur speelse golfies op die sand uitgedra. A day later, Sewes was found on the sand, carried out by playful waves. Ongeskonde, in sy vleur, maar 'n lijk, untouched, in the prime of his life, but a corpse. Hilde Sewes was verbitterd, sy geliefde see, en wat van haar nou? Sy bly sit met 'n kind, 'n dogter genadelik, 'n dogter wat die see nie sou sien nie. Hilde Sewes was bitter, his beloved sea, and what about her now? Here she is with a child, thankfully a daughter that would not see the sea. Sy wou inderdaad onmiddellik haar kind vat en pad gee, maar hier het sy 'n dak oor haar kop gehad en 'n groente tuintjie wat tydelik siel en liggaam aan mekaar kon hou. She wanted to grab her child immediately and leave, but here she had a roof over her head and a small vegetable garden that would feed them and keep them healthy. Toe bied ou Willem Swanepoel nog vir haar 'n werkie in sy slaghuis aan, and then old Willem Swanepoel offered her a job in his butcher. Weldra het die sterk vrou die werk van enige blokman gedoen. She could do the work, the strong woman, of any other worker in the at the butcher, and better. Sy het gebly, voorlopig. She stayed for the meantime. Aanvanklik het die vriendskap tussen Mila en Wyning haar min gepla. Initially, the friendship between Mila and Wyning didn't disturb her at all. Hulle was spotkinders, they were playful children. Dit was sommer van niks anders het om te doen nie. It was because of they didn't have anything else to do. Dat hulle ure lang kon sit en ginnegap, that they could sit and chat about nothing. Skielik stil bly as sy naby kom. Suddenly, they stayed quiet when she came near. Luister met hulle lywe totdat sy weg is. They listened with their bodies until she left. Een aand het hy toe hy van die boot afkom, 'n vis saamgebring. One evening when he came from the boat, he brought a fish. Sommere ou Vredenbaai kabeljoukie ta Hilde. Just a little Vredenbaai kabeljou, Aunt Hilde. Jy weet Wyning, ek hou van my dag af nie van seevis nie. Ek kan nog 'n varswatervis in my liggaam kry. You know Wyning, from my day I don't like fish from the sea. I can still eat a freshwater fish. En die ou Vredenbaaiertjie dan? And this old little fish from Vredenbaai? Vat dit maar vir Erwie en Johnny. Julle werk tog vir hulle. Take it to Erwie en Johnny. You work for them. Ek sal eendag hoër op langs die rivier loop. Kurper soek vir Tahilde. I will walk even higher up the river to find you Kurper. Dis nie nodig nie. It's not necessary. Hulle sommer net hier ander kant die invloed Tahilde. They're just the other side of the estuary, Aunt Hilda. Ek het mos gesê, dis nie nodig nie. Sy het skielik besef dat sy eindelik die uitdaging vergroot. I have told you, it is not necessary. She suddenly realizes that she is pushing the challenge. Sit toch maar die vis daar op die wasbak neer. Just put the fish at the basin. Nie lang daarna het hy weer een vis gebring en was hy klaar met die verskoning. Shortly afterwards, he brought another fish and he already had an explanation. Ons het vandag rarig op school gesit, Tante Hilde. Today we were really above the shoal of fish, Aunt Hilde. 2 uur lang voordat die ander bote agtergekom het wat aangaan. 2 hours before any of the other boats knew what was going on. Maar toe was ons al dik gevang. And but then we had already caught enough. Ek het jou van tevore gesê, I have told you before. By die volgende geleentheid het die verskoning reeds een van opoffering geword. Vis loop nou maar eil, Tante Hilda. Hulle wil nie reis nie. Maar hier is daarom iets. At the next occasion, the excuse was one of sacrifice. The fish is now few and far between, Aunt Hilda. They do not want to come up. So here is something. Hoe is dit dan nou met julle wonderlikste vangstes? What's happened to your wonderful catches now? Dis maar die tyd, Tante Hilda. Die sakvis is ook lastig, die tyd. It's just that time of the year, Aunt Hilda. The sakvis is also irritate at this point. Mila het by die middeldeur ingekom. Haar ma het 2 keer na gekyk. Het sy so vinnig vrou geword? Mila came in at the door. Her mother looked twice and could not believe how fast she has become a woman. Wat hoor ek van sakvis? Vis. Sies, sy het haar neus oordrewe opgetrek. What is this about sakvis? Yuck. And she pulled her nose up. Wat weet jy van visse? Ek het die hele sewes vinnig gevra. What do you know about fish? Her mother asks quickly. Ek weet van sakvis. As sakvis om in jou hoek opgehang het, moet jy als afsny. I know about sakvis. If you have got sakvis on your hook, you need to cut off everything. Sy die kabel jou in sy hand gesin. Dit by hom geneem en haar hand oor die vis laat gaan. She took the kabeljou and put her hand over the fish. Hoe goud is hy hier oor die rug? How golden he is over the back. Jy het nog nie regtig rietbul gesien nie. You haven't really seen the great old kabeljou. Weinig het getril. He was excited. Hy is eindelijk so groen van die blink op sy skof. He is actually so green on the highest side of his back. En het die haie weer baie pak gekry? And that the sharks get a hiding? Hilde Sewes kon sweer, haar dogter is daarop uit om haar te taart. Hilde Sewes could swear that her daughter are doing these things to tease her. Weining het gelag. O, hulle het. Jy hoor net kort hoe lê iemand knippel in. Ons het naderhand kruise op die vaalhaaie gekerf om te kyk of dieselfde een weer wil opklim. Weining laughed. Oh, they did. You could just hear every now and then that someone used a kind of bat, knuppel is a bat, and later on we had to carve crosses to see that whether it was the same one to come up. Mila het saamgelag, en toe, daar het so weer een nog een keer die hoek loop vat. Mila laughed and asked, and then there was again another one that tried to take the hook. Hilde Sewes is sonder 'n woord die huis in. Hilde Sewes walked into the house without saying anything. 'N week later het sy aangekondig dat sy 'n huisie hoër op teen die rivier gehuur het. Die grondjie was groter, 'n ploitjie. Hulle kan selfs die paar slaglammers oorneem. A week later she announced that she rented a little house higher up against the river. It was a little bit bigger, a plot, and they could even look after the sheep. Hulle trek môre. They move tomorrow. Almal het geweet